it's your boy Rodney Perry. I'm bringing you an evolutionary experience. Hey, it's Game Changer.
Hi, this is India with Designer Accessory Adoption. Thanks for watching this video and welcome back to my channel. If you are new or if you are returning, either way, thank you for clicking play. If you're unfamiliar with my upload schedule, I typically love videos every Wednesday covering topics related to fashion, luxury, the pre-loved market, contemporary brands, and also this is going to be my first what I would consider lifestyle video. So I do plan to add some more lifestyle videos here and there. So this is going to be the first one, and we will go ahead and get started with today's topic. So today's topic will be on my journey to natural deodorant from what I would say like is your normal main brand deodorant. And so what I mean by that when I talk about main brand or stream brand or however you want to categorize a deodorant, I'm really talking about those big name deodorants like Degree, Spirits, Secret, all of those, Suave, for example. So those ones that use aluminum pretty much to help control your odor, control sweating, so on and so forth. So I pretty much consider my underarms, they're disobedient is what I'm categorizing them as. And when I say disobedient, I have to wear deodorant. I have to make sure I have no hair under my arms, and hopefully this is not too much information, but I just really want you to understand where I'm coming from. So anyone that has the body chemistry similar to mine, you will totally understand what I'm talking about. So for example, even if I have no hair under my arms, I've showered, 4 hours later, if I have not applied deodorant, I would be musty. So it is really important that a deodorant works for me. I just wanted to kind of make that transition, so I decided to try to switch. And it has taken me 3 different brands to find a winner. So I did want to share my story. And there's some products that you're, you know, wanting to know how they work. Obviously, I'm one person and everybody has a different body chemistry. So I can't tell you whether something's going to work for you or not. You really have to just try it out. But I decided to just share my experience in hopes that it will help someone else in their journey to a natural deodorant as well. So we'll go ahead and get started with the three that I've started with. With the ones that I've tried. I don't know why I can't get that out. But anyway, so first up, I did try this deodorant here, which I grabbed off the table. So the first one that I tried was Smith's, which, like I said, you're going to have to just try it out for yourself. So I tried this one and see if it works for you. But I tried this one out. This was my first introduction to the natural deodorant market. And I don't quite remember the price range for this one, but definitely it seems like the natural deodorants, like all other natural-based products, are a little bit more expensive than your other products that are mass-produced through other chemicals. And it's not that natural products don't have chemicals in them. But even if it's natural, it's a chemical. It's just a naturally occurring chemical versus another chemical that's produced that is not naturally occurring. So I'm my little soapbox as a scientist. Okay, so I started with this Smith's, like I mentioned, and I don't quite remember the price range, but I do remember that it was a little bit more expensive than your like regular run-of-the-mill main market deodorant. This one I said does not work is because my skin was sensitive to it. So I used it the first day, and about 4 hours, like midday through my workday, I noticed my underarms felt sticky. I did not have an odor, but my skin felt weird, and it didn't feel great actually by the evening when I took my shower. So my skin felt rough. I would say it wasn't at the point where I broke out in a rash or anything, but I could tell that my skin was not agreeing with whatever products were made, formulated together to make the Smiths. So I decided to hand that one off to my husband. He tried it for 2 days and ended up with a rash under his arms. So it might be something with the way that our body makeup is that it does not agree with Smiths. But it didn't work for us for those reasons. It was just our skin was very sensitive to it. And I wouldn't even consider my husband having sensitive skin. I think in some areas I might have sensitive skin, but overall I can use like regular detergent and other things. I don't have to buy sensitive formulated things. So with that said, that one did not work for me or my husband. But if it works for you, definitely comment below on your experience. So that way we have both sides of it. But like I mentioned, everybody's different. So one thing that may not work for me may work for someone else. Now, moving on, I did want to say that I learned about it through a podcast called Studio 78. So if you have not heard of that podcast, it's run, the host is Niche Snow. Definitely check out the podcast because it's really a podcast for everyone. If you're just a regular person and you want to hear about new products, new companies, the show is for you. If you're a creative, a business owner, you want to kind of hear about other companies that are coming out, how they're innovating the market, how they're changing the way that they do business processes, so on and so forth, it is the show for you. So definitely check out Studio 40, 78, and I'll throw in the name down here so that way you can go search them on wherever you get your podcasts and listen. Now, that is Sway. So I was introduced to Sway, which comes in this really pretty box here. And as you can notice, this little sticker up here is the sensitive formulation. And the reason I wanted to try Sway is, one, I heard it on the podcast. I also, as a female business owner, also a minority business owner, I really want to try to support the other female businesses, other minority businesses. And the owner of this, of Sway, fits both of those categories. So without... pretty much that's my little shameless plug for supporting women-owned and minority businesses. And so she put in this pretty packaging. So I will give her a pro for the pretty packaging. Pricing-wise, it is expensive. And I know cost is relative to the person. And I consider this expensive. It was, I believe, $18 for the detoxing kit. The detoxing kits come with two items. And then I think with shipping, I probably paid around $25, which is a lot and definitely speaks to me wanting to, I heard that it worked and wanted to support. So here I go. So I tested it out and was hoping that it worked. And the detoxing kit, like I mentioned, you come with two pieces is the detoxing kit. So if you want to divide that up, then maybe 9 and 9. So that's a little bit closer to regular deodorant, but that's still probably about more, $5 more than regular deodorant if you just want to factor that in. And so this is what the little kit comes with. It comes with your liquid roll-on here. And then you have a dusting powder that helps keep you fresh and all of those things. So one, like I said, I did like the packaging. Two is a con. I didn't really like the price. And I did read the instructions. I want to say on the website, and I'm just paraphrasing, it said that while most people will basically conform and be able to just basically be able to use the deodorant right away and find that it works, there are other people, it may take 7 to 10 days. And so I figured I was probably in that 7 to 10 day category. So I actually use this deodorant just to be fully sure that it wasn't going to work for me. I use it for 10 and a half days. So what the instructions tell you to shake it and then you apply it twice a day. And then you also wait till it dries. And then you put this, since it's a liquid roll on, and then you put the dusting powder on for extra freshness to keep your underarms dry and to neutralize odor. So just the thought of one, just having to use two products during the day to me is more cumbersome than I would like to invest. So that's another con to me, is just that this is just too much work. And thinking about it from the other side, just playing devil's advocate, it does say on the box and on the packaging pretty much that you could end up in a situation where you may not have to use this. Once your body kind of accepts it, gets used to it, you may not have to use deodorant every day. So that one could extend out the life of your roll-on, and so that makes it less expensive because then you would be able to kind of double the amount of, double the wear out of it. So if this roll-on only lasts usually a month with everyday application, if we're talking about every other day you don't have to wear it, then we're talking about, you know, extending out to 8 to 2 months or to 3 months, so on and so forth. So I do want to be fair in both of my arguments with that. I just didn't make it to that point. So it does have a slight apple cider vinegar scent to it because it is an apple cider vinegar base. And while I will say most of the scent goes away, I would say like 90% of the scent goes away. And the only reason that you can smell the last bit is unless somebody's just right up under your arms, then you would notice it. But it's not like I can just like kind of lift my underarm and then walk past somebody and somebody would detect, unless they have super sleuth nose, nostrils. If they have super sleuth nostrils, then maybe they would detect it. But I would say mostly that apple cider vinegar scent does go away. For me, I was using it twice a day. Initially, I would put the dusting powder on, and then I would probably forget for several hours to put more on. And then I would notice my underarms don't smell fresh. And so I try to get in a habit of putting the dusting powder on every 2 or 3 hours, which it still did not work for me. So while I was testing it in the comfort of my home, I would put the dusting powder on more frequently just to see, okay, is this going to work if I just continue to put the dusting powder on? And I will tell you, the last probably 3 days, I end up having to wash under my arms at least 2 to 3 times that day to get the funky smell out pretty much and start fresh and reapply. So after 10 and a half days, and like I mentioned, I got to the point where I'm washing under my arms several times a day, I decided this deodorant is not the deodorant for me and I had to move on. So it was an expensive test. But it might work for my husband. He has not tried it yet, but I'm going to save it and I don't want to waste it. So I want to save it and have him use it and see if it works. If it works for him, he can continue to buy it if he wants, which I doubt he's probably going to spend that much on deodorant. So we'll just use it up and then move on. He usually uses whatever deodorant I have. So next up on the list is this one that's been working so far for me for the past week and a half. And that is going to be Love Beauty and Planet. And I purchased their lotion before and did like the lotion. I think I also purchased a hand soap too. So I decided, pricing wise, if you go to, like, for example, I love Target. So I was looking at Target trying to figure out a replacement for that one. And this price range ranged about, I want to say $7 or $8. I got a $2 off coupon, so that put it more into the range of what I would spend on Degree. So I decided to go ahead and try it out. And I will say, like I said, natural deodorant has a range of prices. So at least this was a little bit closer to what I would spend pretty much on a normal deodorant. So I did like this one. It so far has worked. It has no aluminum in it and it's been doing the job. So I'll just show it again. That way, if you want to check it out, you can. And I will try to put a link to Target down below to see if you can purchase this online. I actually will put links to the other two. I definitely know I can find the link to Sway. I'll have to see if I can find a link to Smith's. But I will put whatever links down below so that way I encourage you to kind of check them out, research them on your own. Maybe the ones that didn't work for me will work for you. And I would absolutely love to hear back from you if it does. Otherwise, I thank you for listening and let me know if you're enjoying the content. Thumbs up are encouraged and have a good day.